It's Cobra Guru. I hope you are all well. At first I had not planned to do a third video on Forza Motorsport 6 Apex, but in the end, as I continued to play, I will show you. I said myself, okay, let's do a new one. So as you can see, I have only 4 races left to do in the championship area, I will call it like this. I've made already several races in the special area events, 4 races with 3 gold medals. Yeah, you can see the 2 that are already closed as they change the available events regularly, British GT and rear wheel drives at Rio. And I said to myself that I could show you also what I found interesting in the game at this point, some interesting game mode. Because even if I find the game light, easy, even if, obviously, we can increase the difficulty, but if an Assetto Corsa is even more tough in the handling, in the grip. So, I will show you what I have liked. I've already shown you mostly classic races. This one was classic, basic, except that every opponent was using the same exact car and the objectives of the races was manual shifting. This should be a common sense for everyone. But most important, no driving line at all. But in the end it was not so difficult. This one was much more difficult, much more challenging, as the requirement to get bonus score was no traction control, neither ESP. And it's needed to stay on the track. Because even if it's a bonus objective, if your target is to get the 3 gold medals, you have to succeed them all. So it's needed to stay on tracks. And why is it difficult in here? Because it's in Spa and it's raining. Of course. Here we will have prototype race and here it will be old muscle American cars. Okay, before showing this Spa race, I want to check what was interesting to show you also in the championship. Let's take this one. It's a race monomodel using Ariel Atom. I will do several races today to show you the game as much as possible. So in case you don't know the car, it's a light car called Ariel Atom. I will check the driving assistance. Yeah, I'm still at 51% and it's only manual shifting required, so already set it up. Drive at time at 55%. Oula. I will put it back at 40 for the video. Okay, let's try. This is a standard race, yes, just need to finish 6 minimum. It's a small track with a very light car. Damn it. I've already lost 1 bonus. I went outside track limits. You can notice and it's very sensible. For this one it can be considered tough in the case you target the 3 gold medals, because you will need to race focused in order to not make any mistake to get all objectives. It's not obvious to stay on the good line and not make mistakes, as the car is really light and nervous. Can't brake too late neither. Depending the race you have to do, those different objectives are, you know, a way to increase the interest and difficulty of the game. Once again, fail breaking point. I will be able to finish 6th, which is the main objective. Can be a little bit on the curbs, but you've seen you have to be very careful as you can go out of tracks pretty easily. As I have also shown you in my first videos on Forza Motorsport 6, nothing prevents you to be rough. Okay, it's not fair, but well. See, I'm not the only one to make mistakes. So now I will attempt to get higher in rank and try to finish 3rd. 2 laps to go, including the one I am finishing. I've already lost the objectives to not go out of the tracks. I will attempt to win the race by cutting inside. And I won't make it. I failed again this corner, damn! And the first now is too far. This one I will be able to overtake. You will ask why, once again, I failed my corner. But because this time, and with time, you can feel that the tires are not responding well anymore. Especially if you drive too aggressively like me, or slide too much. I've noticed that with time. So, 3 objectives out of 4, which will result in a less good score. Can see that my best score was 1.2 million. If you want to play and focus on getting the medals, you just need to make the best score with all objectives. This was a standard race. This mode was interesting. You had to beat the Stig in the KenigSegg Jira. It was fun. I've been able to beat him at 40% difficulty. I am attempting it at 55%. But it's fun. bronze hatch races with real racing cars. It will be cool. But first of all, I want to show you this one. This race was really tough. I will stick with the GTR. Spa with rain. Wow. Knowing that, the fact that to do this race you have to deactivate traction control and ESP with rain and to stay on the track. Probably that with the steering wheel it will be better in order to manage the acceleration and braking than using the pad. So, driving assistance, I deactivate everything. And now, try to stay on tracks. Let's go! I can tell you that it's sliding a lot. It's not the fact of sliding. It's more the fact of avoiding mistakes to stay on tracks. And of course in here, no cutting corner at all. Get the aspiration, go 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 go. Great! Sliding. are so close. Far from the first, I don't think you would be able to catch him and win the race. No! Damn it, jeez! Fail this. You see, it's really tricky. A little mistake and you lose objectives. I'm not happy here, because I was just at the limit. Well, I don't get the system of perfect or correct corner or overtaking. It's really subjective, I find. Sometimes when the objectives are to do perfect overtaking or cornering, it's not what I prefer. Do you think that in the WEC, the driver are focused on making perfect corner? I don't think so. Their objective is to go where they can, especially when there is traffic around them. They are just trying to go the fastest as possible while overtaking other cars. Disappointed that I didn't win the race, and of course that I failed the objectives to not get out of the tracks. Damn it. Well. I already got the 3 gold medals in here. So you see what level of difficulties there can be in some event. No one says not something if you push others, eh? So I wonder if it's taken in account for my driver tag. I can imagine if it's the case, mine will push a lot. Okay, so one lap to do. Just finished the prototype race on Yas Marinas. Oh, erk. I don't like this track at all. Okay, Formula 1 is there, but don't like it. And now on Brands Hatch, I will try my best as I like this track very much. I really enjoy this race, as there is no ABS, no traction control, no AESP neither. A real race for men. Okay, let's go for a good braking in the inside. Yes! So, now that I'm first, it's my real problem. I always make a mistake and lose everything. It reminds me something. If some of you, or you play racing games, you like them of course, but you may also like watching racing on TV. And as it's my case, I was watching some years ago also Japanimation series Initial D. And I've noticed that I'm often like Takumi was at the beginning of the series. Strong and very focused when behind. Taking the best line, attempting to go as fast as possible to catch the one in front. But once in front, I lose concentration and I do bullshit. As also I'm speaking to you, it don't help, doesn't help. But I will try my best, as I want to win this one, to show you also that I am not as bad as it can look. Of course, I am not a professional driver at all. I don't have that level. Probably I wouldn't be able neither to be in the GT Academy, for example. But I want to show you that in my first two videos, when I started to present you the game, the level of difficulty of opponents was probably 25%, maybe 40 sometimes, but not sure. But the driver assistance was at 51% around all the time. But in here, as you can see, I am able to win the race without most of those assistance. So in fact, I'm not as bad. Difficulty at 40%, driver assistance 64%. Okay, if I am in the top 500, I will be happy. Whoa, 273rd, not bad at all in fact. So I hope you got the idea of the game. I have to admit it bothers me a little bit. I don't like this kind of race with special objectives to earn 3 medals to have the best score possible. For me, it's not in the real spirit of a realistic simulation. For me, a simulation, I've already said it, it's Assetto Corsa. Why? Because in Assetto Corsa, if you don't have the level of one race, if you feel it's too difficult, you can simply reduce your position to 90% or 80% or even lower in order to train, get more confident, practice and become better driver. But you are on the tracks with everyone with the same car, okay, maybe except in some category like GT3. But make race with objectives to drive without helps, or to do perfect cornering, perfect overtaking, or to not go out of the track, etc, etc. Like I said earlier, I've watched the two races of the WEC in September. The objectives of the race is to win it. Do you think that if they make a mistake on a break at the end of a straight line and go out of tracks a little bit, the race will stop like you lose? You lost? It's over? No, no, no. Of course, if they do it on purpose several times, they will get a drive through. But this is another thing. Well, I've shown you several game modes. You have Mono Model Race, Challenge, Under Rain, more or less difficult. This one I had trouble a little bit. This one was very cool. I have still some races to do left. It's a free technical demo game, so do not deprive yourself to get it. As you can see, those two are new ones. Those events will end on the 19th of September and will be replaced by two new ones, and so on. So this game has new content regularly in those event parts, which is a good thing. But well, I stick on my feeling, frankly speaking. It's a good time to spend playing it. It may help you to progress a little bit. The only issue is that you need a Win 10 computer. Thank you for watching. Have fun, everyone. Play a lot. And above all, take care of you. See ya next time. Bye bye.